Leslie Polack, the manager of health and wellness at Sparrow, is with us right here in front of our AT&T microphone. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
So Senator Schmidt did not run in the Bayshore Marathon.
No.
And marathons aren't for everybody.
Not me.
A bucket list kind of thing. Not you either? You seem like you could run. But you're going to offer something that's more manageable for people very soon.
Yes.
But we're less important.
True. This is an event targeted more towards our youth. So Sparrow's commitment to improving health and wellness in our community. We're giving a great opportunity this weekend for children to run a 1 mile fun run.
Oh.
At Cooley Law School Stadium.
In the stadium?
In the stadium.
Even
they start
more fun.
And they end. Yeah, yeah.
What time does that start?
First heat will start at 9 a.m. for Michigan Mile.
Okay, so you're going to do it by ages?
Or yes.
What do you mean by
break
heat?
Break it down by ages because we have almost 1,700 children running.
Wow.
Ages 5 through 13.
Too bad they're not on some kind of giant treadmill that could create enough energy.
It probably
seems like,
because
the noise, too, will have 1,700 kids would blow the roof off the place. There is no roof. But will they really run in the concourse, like all the way around or on
they
the
start
field?
They start on the field. Oh. They go up the steps and they do about a mile around Cedar, Shiawassee, come on through. And then they end up on the field where they cross and we give them their medal.
Super cool, because you don't normally get to go on the field
either.
And can parents take pictures and all that sort of
there's
thing?
There's pictures, there's Sparty, there's Big Log, there's a bounce house, there's face painting, clowns.
And you've got auto owners support, MSUF, CU, and Meyer, and how much does it cost for families to come do that?
It's pretty affordable. At this point, you can register on race day for $18. You can register Friday at Playmakers, another great partner in the event for us. As well as WKAR and Jessica Artaby Insurance and Genera Photography. So it's a really wonderful community partnership event.
And that's just, the 18 is just for the child.
Yep.
Parents don't have to pay to get in and watch.
No, and parents can either run with their child if they're a little bit nervous, or Playmakers provides their running buddies, which are individuals who will actually run the mile with.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's neat. And keep them out of the street and all that sort of thing, I guess, too. And so the parents can cheer them on.
Yes.
This is great, and it's on the 3rd of June, which is Sunday.
Saturday,
starting at?
First heat starts at 9 a.m.
9, and then so is there a website where people can see what time they should be there and all that kind of thing?
They can. They can go to sparrow.org/Michigan Mile, and all the information is there, or call 1-800-SPARROW.
Okay, and the reason I know the 3rd of June is Tony Cuthbert, our director here, and the orchestra is really disappointed that the 3rd of June is on a Saturday this year. Because what we do on...
He's scowling.
He is.
He's like, where are you going with this?
Because normally on the 3rd of June on this program, we play Neil Diamond.
Oh, jeez.
His song Desiree, we use it every single segment.
Oh, really?
Because it starts out by saying, you know the song Desiree, Neil Diamond? He says, it was the 3rd of June. And so we play however many times that is through 3 hours in the morning. And he's very relieved that it's a Saturday.
And darn
year.
It won't be a work day, huh?
Yeah, no. So we won't get to hear Neil Diamond 700 times that morning. Or probably not in Cooley Law Stadium, where those kids want something a little more.
They probably aren't aware of Neil Diamond.
No, that's, as we were speaking earlier about the lingo of kids, even Tony doesn't know Neil. Leslie Polack is the manager of health and wellness at Sparrow. What's the fastest you've ever driven in a car? Tell the truth.
Within the speed limit?
That can't possibly be true. But I noticed
I've never been in like a fast race car.
Well, Takuma Sato was. He won the Indianapolis 500 this weekend. And Chris Gall is with us right now on our AT&T line from visitindy.com. How was the weekend, Chris?
Oh, it was epic. The rain held off. And to your point, the first Japanese winner, Takuma Sato, and his paycheck, $2.5 million for driving around the famous oval track. So that's not a bad paycheck for a couple hours of work.
Sure isn't. How about the celebrity scene? Was it Jake Gyllenhaal? Did you get to meet him?
I got to shake hands with Jake. He was very excited to be there. He was with one of the Boston Marathon survivors who lost both of his legs on that attack a few years ago. They were the official starters and were in and around the pits in the garage area. That was really neat to see them together and to learn a little bit more about that tragedy in the movie. In addition to that, we had a lot of Vice President of the United States, Mike Pence, was there. He was going around the track, and he's been there for the last 20 straight races, so he said he did not want to miss this one. Of course, it's a sea of humanity, but also a sea of patriotic people because it's Memorial Day weekend. So it was fun to have him there as well.
What about Negan from The Walking Dead? He was in the pace car, I'm told.
He was in the pace car. He was a little. He was very nervous ahead. You could tell because again, you've got the world watching, And you know, the pace car itself, he was going 100 plus for quite a few laps, but he was, I would say, very floored afterwards, and went straight up to the pagoda to grab a libation and maybe take the edge off. But it was a fantastic race. There were 34, maybe 35 lead changes, which makes for an exciting race. And at one point, there were five cars lined up side to side going into the first turn, which is very dangerous, but also very fun to watch.
There was a big wreck, huh?
There was. It's amazing. A lot of, you know, sometimes on the streets, unfortunately, we go 40 miles an hour and die. This driver, Scott Dixon, ran into Jay Howard, flipped end over end, hit the safer wall, and walked away without a scratch. Really speaks to the car and its safety and how far these cars have come. There have been 13 deaths while racing in the history of 101 races here in Indianapolis, but we were clean and safe for the race yesterday.
Did you run into Roger Penske, speaking of running into people?
I didn't. It was top of mind. I saw him from maybe 40 to 50 yards away, and it would have been slightly inappropriate to yell at that format, but I was at the victory celebration last night and did not see him there. That's where I was hoping to really move the needle on your quest to play golf with him at Augusta, but we're going to get it done sooner or later.
Okay. I'm going to see you in Indy, I hope, sometime soon, and congratulations. Visit Indy, allsummer.com, visitindy.com for a cool place to take your kids, whether the race is on or not. You can always visit the track and get a tour and even go in a real-life race car if you want to. Congratulations, Chris!